active power, reactive power, apparent power, and power factor. Have you ever thought about the meaning of all these terminologies? Stick with me till the end of this video to hit all these concepts. Bring an AC source, a switch, and a lamp. Connect them together. Flip the switch to have a closed loop circuit. And boom! The current will start flowing to illuminate the lamp. Now, voltage, as we know, is a sine wave. Current will be also a sine wave in phase with voltage, because the lamp is a resistive load. What is in phase? In phase means that the two waveforms starts and ends at the same time. To calculate the power, we have to multiply the two waveforms together. In the first half of a period, positive times positive will equal to a positive value. In the second half of a period, negative times negative will equal to a positive value. And so on. So power waveform will always be positive. This waveform called instantaneous power, which means that power changes with time. Calculate the average power for this waveform, which is the useful power we use to illuminate a lamp or rotate a motor. This useful power is the active power P. Let's bring back our AC source and connect it now to a coil. This coil is a pure inductive load with no resistance. Now, current will be shifted by 90 degrees, or current lag voltage by 90 degrees. As we did before, multiply the two waveforms together. In first quarter, positive times negative will generate a negative value. In the second quarter, positive times positive will equal to a positive value. In the third quarter, negative times positive will equal to a negative value. And at last, in the fourth quarter, negative times negative will generate a positive value. Calculate now the average for the power waveform. It's equal to zero. No active power or no useful power here. It's a power that is going back and forth. We need to deal with this waveform. So we will call the maximum point as Q, or reactive power. I'll call it here QL, because it's due to inductive load. Similarly, connect our AC source to a capacitive load. The current will be shifted by 90 degrees in the opposite way, or current will lead voltage by 90 degrees. Let's multiply now the two waveforms. Positive times positive will equal to positive. Positive times negative will equal to negative. Negative times negative will equal to a positive value, and at last, negative times positive will equal to a negative value. As we see here, we can't have an average power or active power here, so we will call the maximum point as Q, or reactive power. I will add C here to Q to be QC, because it's due to capacitive load. So, in phasor diagram form, if V and I are in phase, active power P will be produced. But if I is shifted by 90 degrees, reactive power Q will be produced. What if our load is a mixture between resistive and inductive load? Now we will have an active power and reactive power at the same time. And the current will be shifted by an angle between 0 degree and 90 degree, depending on the load. So now we have P and Q together, which is called apparent power S. So S is equal to P plus JQ. In math, J means P and Q are perpendicular to each other. So S is the total power that the load consumes. The angle between P and S is called phi, which is the same phase shift degree between voltage and current. I like the analogy of a coffee cup. It has a real coffee, which is tasty and useful, and we drink it. But also there is a froth, which is not useful, but it takes a space inside the cup and prevent more coffee to be filled inside the cup. So S is just like the cup itself. P is just like the useful and tasty coffee, and Q is like froth, which is not useful at all. Here we came to the point of power factor. Power factor is how much of the coffee will be filled inside the cup compared to the size of the cup. So power factor is P over S, or cosine phi. As the angle phi decreases, cosine phi or power factor will increase, or P will be much closer to the value of S. Hopefully, this video has helped you to understand the meaning of each terminology. You'll find some useful resources in the description below. Leave a comment if you have any question, or you have any recommendation for the next videos, or just to say hi. Thank you. See you next time. Bye.